So not too long ago, I made a video telling you all about this woman who posted me on her social media, and she was so disgusted how she had a trans server, and she was so mortified her children had to witness this and this and that and a little bit of that too. Well, she came back to my job today. Not only was she at my job, she was in my section. Again, I was her server. Again. But this time, I was suited and booted. I was ready. I get all that myself, and I feel like that is a very important thing when a woman is independent.
My mouth's a moisten, the liquid is just going everywhere.
That's trigger points. Everybody has trigger points. Let's just be honest. Those are my trigger points.
Yoplait yogurt is like, I hit every single option possible. Baby, I did like baking. I think if you. Even though that's just a label. We're trans women, but we're still human at the end of the day. We want what everybody else wants, and that's just to be loved and accepted. That's all we damn want. Yes, love and acceptance.
This is what we're going to do, because I feel that I'm getting out of my character. So, this is what we're going to do.
It's time to be alive, isn't it?
Mind that we came a long way.
If you haven't already, be sure to like, share, and subscribe. It's free to subscribe. It's free to support. Let's jump right into what we gotta jump into. So today is May 1st. Happy May to everyone. Mother's Day is upon us. Cinco de Mayo is upon us. Is something else coming up besides graduations? No, nothing else really is coming up that I can think of. My mother's birthday is coming up, which is on Mother's Day this year. How fabulous. Let's get all the pleasantries out the way. Not too long ago, I remember telling you all about an experience I had with a guest who took a photo of me and posted it on her Facebook and was very nasty and very disgusting towards me. And I even said in that video how I wish that she would come to my job again. So we can redo this experience. Because see, before I was not aware that she was taking pictures of me. Before, I was not aware that she was disgusted by me. Before, I was naive and thinking that she was just there to eat her food and get her ass on down the road. But this go round, oh, I was looking for her. So here I am minding my own business like I'm always doing, trying to make an honest living. And I see this lady, she sits in my section, treated her like I treat all my other servers, because quite frankly, I don't remember the bitch like that. Like, her photo, her picture is not like a reoccurring photo in my mind. But she sat down, and immediately she sat down, she gave me a look. And I was like, what's wrong with her? Who pissed her grits? You know what I'm saying? So she gave me a look. I didn't think nothing of it. I thought of it, but not too deep into it, okay? So I went and took their orders, and I had some regulars who were sitting right next to them. My regulars actually getting ready to leave, and then I had some guests sitting on the other side of her. She was in between two guests. Her and her, I believe that was her great-grandmother, because she looked even older than she was. I would hope that was her great-grandmother who she was with. But they were there together. The energy was very off. Like, you can tell she didn't really want to look me in my face. Or she was just very awkward. And I kept saying, something's not right with this lady. And then the more I thought about it, I was like, she looks familiar. Now it's clicking. She looks familiar. So I wasn't sure. So I went and asked one of my coworkers. I'm like, hey, I have a photo because I have a picture of her, of that post she made about me. I have a picture of her profile. So I'm like, does this lady look familiar? She goes, no, she doesn't look familiar. I'm like, go look at table 10 or table 9, whatever table. I'm like, go look at that table. She goes, oh my God, that's her. I said, oh, is it? So I politely sashayed on over there. I'm like, hello, ladies, is everything okay? And like, oh, yeah, we're fine, ma'am. We're fine, ma'am. Remember, she don't too much care for, like, my kind. And she was very disrespectful, made this post, how I was disgusting and all this type of shit on her social media and how I'm a man with a wig, but yet you're still referring to me as ma'am, right? Okay, follow me here. So I asked her, I said, is your name Amy? Immediately she goes, yeah, why? I just did like this. Never mind. And I turned around and kept going because I had to remind myself I'm at work. So not too much. I can't do too much. I can do something, but I can't do too much. I just said, is your name Amy? Yeah, why? Never mind. As I'm turning around, she gets hyper because now she knows, bitch, I know who you are. See, she wasn't aware that I know that she posted me on her page because her page is private. But people talk. That's how I got the screenshots. People talk. So when I turned around and said, never mind, she goes, no, come tell me. How do you know me? I walked my own off, ignored her. And I went to the back. I took some deep breaths because I felt my blood start to boil because I started thinking about all the mean and evil things she was saying about me. And now this lady is here in my section thinking that I'm about to serve her. Oh, and I had to keep reminding myself, bitch, you're at work. Don't do nothing that you're going to regret. Don't fuck up this good job for this home. So I walk back out there because I have other tables to take care of. I have other tables to tend to. So I go check on my other tables. Everyone's doing fine. Everyone's great. Here go Amy, big ass. Come here, excuse me, come here. I want to ask you a question. How do you know me? I want to know, how do you know my name? I go, well, Miss Amy, I don't know if you're aware of this, but I caught wind of a very nasty post you made about me. What nasty post? I didn't take a picture of you. Never said she took a picture of me. She did, but I never said that to her. She told her herself. See, that's that shit she had in her mouth. I never took a picture of you. That was my sister. I said, Miss Amy. In this exact tone, I said, Miss Amy, it doesn't matter if it was your sister, your brother, your mother, or your father. A picture of me was posted on your profile with your name on it. Therefore, you are responsible for that. You had my photo of me while I was at work on your page trying to make me a mockery and a clown. Oh, I'm going to stop you right there. I never try to make a mockery of you. I said, Miss Amy, nothing you said on that post was uplifting, positive, or just flat out nice. You talked very disgustingly about me. Wrap this fucking shit up. You're a stupid motherfucker. You are stupid. She went off because she couldn't handle a conversation. Because I'm willing to have uncomfortable conversations. But that's the thing. It's conversations. This bitch want to argue and she wants to fight and she wants to make a scene. So now I'm a fag. Now I'm a man with a wig on. Now I'm all these names. She's calling me all these ugly names. Sitting down, as I was standing above her. Remained calm. Then her great grandmother points her finger and says, you need to walk away. And I raised my left arm and I pointed at her just like this. I said, you speak when spoken to. The great grandmother says, oh, excuse me. I said, and I'm done with you. Now back to you, Amy. I said, you are the epitome of a hurt soul. You have so much hate and aggression towards a person that you don't know to the point where I don't even feel upset, Miss Amy. If anything, I feel sorry for you. I pity you. Just like I said in my video about her, I told her to her face. And it felt so good to tell her this. Because I like to tell bitches to their face how I feel about them. I said, Miss Amy, I pity you. Because anytime you can allow a complete stranger to have this much power over you, my love, you have lost the battle. Fuck all that. Go get my to-go box. I'm leaving this motherfucking place. I'm about to go. Bitch, fuck you. I ought to spit on you. See, now that's when the little ratchet tries to sneak out. But I was holding on to that bitch. I was clutching her by the throat. I said, ooh, Maya, shut up. Ooh. But it was something about when this hoe said she gonna spit on me. All that, I froze. Everybody in the section, girl, everybody gasped because they thought I was about to slap the dog shit out of her throat with a hand wide open. I just stopped and I clutched my pearls because I was like, and I looked at it and I leaned in. I said, I'm about to walk away. It's about to get bad. And I said, just then I walked away. She was steady going. I left. Because mind you, Amy is an older woman. She's an older woman who limps when she walks, so she's handicapped. I told you I thought the bitch was a fucking crackhead. But, and I know what I'm capable of doing. And I know the situation by me being a black trans woman in the South. Had I slapped the shit out of Amy, had I been in jail. Okay, so I said, let me go on about my business. I said, I'm going to let the manager handle her because I'm gone. So we go get the manager. The manager comes out there. And her great-grandmother, Amy's great-grandmother, tells the manager, I hit her. I seen her in the bathroom. And I hit her in her arm with the bathroom door. So now, out of nowhere, I was in the bathroom fighting the bitch. I'm like, See, people like that scare me. People who make up lies like that, some serious ass accusations, honey, that scares me. She tells the manager this, all this, and how she'll never be back and all this type of shit. And I want to say this to my manager, Rebecca is her name, honey. I've never, ever felt like this towards an employer in my life. When Rebecca looked at that woman and said, well, she's family, and we don't discriminate based off someone's sexual identity, race, anything like that. My heart was so warm because, like, wow. Even if that bitch had to just say that, it felt good to hear. Like, damn, okay. These bitches got my back. Because right is right, wrong is wrong. And I love that. I've never felt like that. I was so appreciative to just be able to hear that and witness that. Because, wow, that's an amazing feeling. To know that your employer has your back. That's like, wow, okay. 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 And the only thing that felt better is when the people around, my guests, people who don't even fucking know me, y'all, people around, and people who were someone like a different server's guest, their guest was even chiming in. Like, yeah, she didn't do that. Everyone, it was anonymous. Everyone was telling the manager the truth, which was, I was not the aggressor. She was the aggressor. And she tried to make it sound like I was the aggressor. God, it was a great feeling. And the even better feeling is to know that Miss Amy is banned from my job. I will never have to worry about Miss Amy again at that job. At that location. Okay, honey? So I hope she feels better about herself. I don't regret anything, y'all. I felt so good. It's one thing to read a bitch on YouTube, but to be able to read that bitch in person to her face, because see, the people think that you have to get out of character and get loud and curse to get your point across. I read Amy so effortlessly without raising my voice, without having to curse at her, because I knew I already won. Because anytime a bitch allow another bitch to have that much power over them and not even knowing them, they won. Amy, I won. And you thought you was going to win because you thought people was going to have your back on the evil-ass mentality. And although everyone is not, quote-unquote, Team Maya, like, everyone's not the biggest fan of a black trans woman, some people are. Get over it. Some people actually do like people from just being people. Not everybody's small-minded and judgmental. So that meant so much to me. No job is perfect. And I'll be lying if I got in front of this camera and said, this job is. This job has its problems. Trust me when I tell you that. But the good definitely outweighs the bad. And today was one of those examples because all of my coworkers who were there rallied up around me, checked on me, made me feel, okay, y'all really care, okay? Because this is nothing new to me. Unfortunately, I deal with bigots all the time, but, you know, what is new to me is having that much support from people. So I appreciated that. I even wrote about it on Facebook today, but I deleted it like 10 minutes after because I shared my experience like I'm sharing with you all now. I shared my experience on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. 10 minutes later, I deleted it because I didn't like the comments. Everyone was in the comments basically saying that they're sorry I had to go through this. And, you know, they're being very concerned, which I'm very appreciative of that. But I personally didn't like the comments because I didn't want it to come off like I was looking for pity. I don't need pity for nobody. And I'm not saying that I was receiving pity, but I just felt like I was getting pity from the people. And I didn't want to be that because I'm nobody's victim, especially Amy's. I'm no one's victim. I was just wanting to share my experience because it was just horrible. But I didn't want to share it in a way that it came off like I was trying to get a pity party. I don't need a pity party. I live this life 7 days a week, 24 hours a day. I don't need pity. I don't need sorrows. I just need people to know this, and this is the reason I want to share this. Life for a black trans woman in the South is not daisies. Like, people see me all the time laughing and smiling. Y'all have no idea the stuff I have to deal with. Like, and no one ever sits back and thinks, is Maya okay? Because yes, I can handle situations like this, obviously. I can. But does that mean I have to? So it meant so much to know that my job had my back today. That meant a lot to me. It did. Made a bitch want to go back tomorrow. Amy's a fucking cunt, so fuck her. And an ugly one at that, honey. You gonna be a cunt, honey. At least get a fish. I mean, come on now. Step it up, Miss Girl. But, yeah, that's how my day went today. Child. Siri, play Yolanda Adams' Victory Is Mine. Clock me. I'm about to work. I'm about to go. I'm gonna wash this makeup off. See, that's the problem. There's too many Amy's in this world. You hoes going to sleep with a face full of makeup. Wash that off your face. I ain't got the best skin, but damn, I try to maintain what I do get. Bye, y'all. Happy Pride, especially to you, Miss Amy. Happy Pride. Raggedy bitch.